Good afternoon, all. Yeah, of course, when Peter introduces me, he already tells a lot about what we do. And my organization is called PROOV, which is in Dutch Pro Public Transport. And of course, proving that something else is possible, and especially the next step of charging, where you don't have to worry about wires, about poles in the road. For instance, when Norway will be really successful and half of the vehicles will all have to use poles to load their vehicles. In inner cities, what will happen? That's not the future we believe. We believe that it can be done differently. When you have energy, electric energy, you can transport it by wire, but you also can do it by magnetic field. And that's what we do, by induction. And you all know induction, of course, from your toothbrush, from your induction cooking, and so on. It's I call this presentation the drivers and boundaries for unplugged e-mobility. We are a strong believer that it's something that really can work, and we already proved it. In the last 4 years, we worked very hard on getting a new generation of chargers, high-powered modules of 60 to 100 kilowatts for a bus, 200 kilowatts of charging, very fast for trucks, 300 kilowatts, it's all possible. The idea is, like it's demonstrated here, that you have a sort of Lego blocks in the road and you drive your bus above it. When it's on the right position, it charges for 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 4 minutes. What is needed? The batteries in the bus just ask for the current, and then you can drive kilometers. Yeah, maybe 4 minutes charging, 10 kilometers driving, something like that. That's approximately what you can do. So it's logistically seen in a city, it's very easy to integrate. Especially when you have one charger, you can drive in 1 hour 6 buses over the same charger. And probably there are cross lines. And most of the times it's in railway stations where you have most buses waiting for train passengers to go into the bus and follow their electric journey. And what I found in the last 4 years is that when you want to do something as an entrepreneur in this EV business, it's not easy because it's a sort of pushing the revolution. you're in yourself, you're trying to get people convinced. So we did a lot of work in market development and bring it into minds that electric buses, most of the people thought in the beginning, they are so big and heavy, you can't charge them. But what's very nice is that the business case for electric buses is now break even with diesel buses, with fossil fuel buses. And I can explain to you later how that's going to be. So, how it's done. It's of course all about what this proof is doing is giving you the opportunity just to, for instance, pay per month a certain amount of money, and we do everything. But that's not the important thing. The important thing is that you can use green energy very easy to charge your vehicles by an automatic system. So, for instance, when you have a car, we did to with our German partner, the Daimler. Daimler worked together. We did in Berlin a test with a Mercedes B-Class with a small inductive charger. It's approximately this big, this size. You put it on your parking lot. You just park your car, you go to sleep or you go to work, you come back and everything is fine because your battery is always charged. You don't have to do anything. And that's what the next level will be, is that you can drive. And during driving you can charge. It's very difficult at the moment. We are working on that. But it was the basic idea. Just drive and charge. Use the grid of the trains that most of the times in Holland go parallel. The train lines go parallel to the roads. So you can use already paid by the taxpayers the energy stations, the travo houses, and charge your roads, and then you can drive. That's the future. But then we needed a business case, of course. And we need, of course, clean cities. Everybody needs clean cities. And one of the things that we got against us was the opinion that electric driving is still polluting a lot of CO2, fine dust, NOx, and so on. But the fact is, of course, that that's what we saw in 2010. I show you later on a small movie about that. That when we were studying what's happening really in a railway station, is that a lot of people concentrate there, and a lot of buses are standing there, and their average usage of fuel is 2.5 liter, 1 on 2.5, so 1 liter, 2.5 kilometers. But when they drive away from a railway station, it's 1 on 40. So the amount of NOx, fine dust, CO2, and so on, in the area, especially where the people are walking around, most of the time younger people and elderly, the concentrations are very high. We did a lot of measurements and used the RIVM to help us with that, and make calculation programs, and we found out that one bus is approximately 50 cars for pollution, and we can do something about the pollution around railway stations. And that's exactly the spot where all the buses come together, so we thought, let's use infrastructure that's not visible, it's in the road, and it's completely automated for buses, taxis, and in the near future it will be for trucks. And then you can clean your cities, because it's on the Ecomobile 2 days ago, I spoke to the politicians from the Ministry of Economic Affairs and Infrastructure and Environment, and they were so relaxed on this issue. And of course they know the map where you see that Holland has the highest level of pollution in Europe, and especially Rotterdam, where the Ecomobile was situated. And it's something that you can do something with it. The numbers that show that when you have a sort of zone where you don't allow traffic, it's very difficult, and you can do all kinds of things to get rid of all the fossil fuel cars, but then you limit your mobility. Better is to go to the source and just don't pollute anymore. And start with your public transport. People breathe every day, every hour, in a city, a lot of fine dust. It's giving extra costs to the environment, healthcare, to the buildings that become black. It gives a lot of vibration and so on, especially the big buses. So we can gain a lot on health in inner cities by going directly and to electric buses. No fossil fuels anymore. And of course it's not it's something that's meant for the future, for the children that we have all the time, that's the story. But we're living now, and we can do something good, of course, coming from the era of vertical thinking. I call it vertical thinking. We're all thinking about, okay, let's go into the ground, dig a hole, get out from the thick crust of the earth, those fossil fuels. Then we look at the earth with a very thin layer where all the living creatures live in, compared to the enormous earth that we have. And we just burn. In the inner city of Utrecht, for instance, we burn every day 3 swimming pools of fuel. If you do it publicly and everybody sees it, then you have something going on. But we do it every week. That's something to think about. Another thing is that it's an that's not only a responsibility of politics. It's also that as a citizen you can be connected to electric transport. For instance, you make your own electric energy by wind or solar. Why can't you use that energy to have your bus driving? That's a system that we are really implementing shortly. We will also do it in Utrecht. Energy corporations making energy where all people can connect, bringing buy in green energy, make your own energy and use it to get a lower price for your driving with your electric public transport, for instance. So get the people involved. There are many other ideas of doing that. I want to show you how the system works, of course. This is, and I had to make it very short, so that's why I speed up a little. This is a bus in Den Bosch. It will drive above our charger, a second generation charger. The first generation is already 10 years old. I'll show you later. And here you look under the bus. I did the movie, so it's not so. I don't have a very steady hand. Here we drop down a section which is 4 centimeters above the ground. We have an efficiency of a measured efficiency of 94% of energy transfer, and then the energy. Yeah, you don't see anything. It's just this, and then the bus drives. So in 2010 we drove for 1 year, did a lot of tests for also on how do the people like it, what is the amount of radiation to the environment, and did all kinds of tests on the technology. And what we found out is it's really safe, it's very efficient, and it's not costly at all. The infrastructure, for instance, is 1/6 of the bus price, of an electric bus price. So you can gain that very easily, because every kilometer you drive is fossil fuel is much more expensive than driving on electricity. So it's a break even in 4 years when you have the right configuration. And then I want to show you what we did in 2010. With the sponsor, it's just Stichting Doen. We drove through the city. Here you see that this is the old version, where the bus, where you can still see the drop-down mechanism, and the bus drives through the city centers. It's very quiet. It's more people waited. Really, for to go with this bus instead of the bus coming after 8 minutes. And one of the streets that where we saw that every 22 seconds a bus drove through, we did interviews and we asked, how do you like that? All those big buses going through your street, how do you experience here? You're working here. Then they said, oh, the noise, we get used to it. Noise we get used to. Yeah, every night we have some black stuff coming out of our nose, but we get used to it. So there's not really a problem. Yes, there is a problem. The problem was shaking, vibration. Every 22 seconds there was vibration. The bus starting up, all those buses coming by. And it's something that you don't have with electric buses. Then the economics. I already told you that you can't be an entrepreneur when you don't earn any money. And of course, the only thing that we did last 4 years was investing. Now we have our first our first, second, yeah, there are six projects already on the way in different countries, and one of the countries is of Utrecht, where we go with a real concession, no subsidies involved, and the idea is that there are 160 buses involved in the first part of the concession and 140 in the second part. And what we want to do is to get as much as possible electric buses from those 140. So we have to perform, really. And we will start in December with driving one bus line with all the buses through the city center of Utrecht. But also London is interested. Milton Keynes will drive with the IPT technology. Montreal will drive with the IPT technology. Glasgow will drive with the IPT technology. Some Eastern European countries are interested. Italy is interested. So we have approximately 40 leads, but we need, of course, projects in the Netherlands too, I believe. So about the economics, it's cheaper than diesel buses when you have enough kilometers and enough buses on the lines. The sum is very easy. An electric bus costs 300,000, the expensive ones 400,000, the cheaper one 250,000. And that's why is it cheaper? Because the battery pack that you normally need, the enormous battery pack, is not needed when you do opportunity charging every time. You charge every time, you give it a little energy, just enough to go around, give it a little energy again, and go around. Of course, there are some battery limitations now, because you can't put an enormous amount of energy in a very small battery, but the batteries are a factor four smaller, three to four smaller. So the cost of a battery is approximately 500 euros per kilowatt hour. And a BYD bus has 320 kilowatt hour, and a European electric bus has something like 240 kilowatt hour. So it's an enormous amount. We drive with 90 kilowatt hour, and we believe that it will be sufficient. And we will not only be sufficient, but it will also have enough spare to drive around in a couple of rounds without charging at all. So then, yeah, of course, you have to add to the business case the cost of the infrastructure, costing approximately 50,000 per bus when you have six buses. So then you have a price. The cheapest price will be 300,000 euro for a bus of 350 when it's more middle-sized. So you have to overcome 100,000 or 150,000 euros that you have to invest more in every bus. Then you say, okay, that's too much. But of course, it's all about total cost of ownership. I heard it also from the Norwegian guy. And then it comes. You drive 10 years. You drive in a concession normally. You drive, now let's make it easy, 100,000 kilometers per year with a bus. Every kilometer you can gain 0.3, 0.4 euro cent per kilometer. So when it's, for instance, 0.4, it's 40,000 euros per year. So after a couple of years, you have it break even. And it's very rough, but it gives you an idea of where we're going. When we started 4 years ago, the bus was 750,000 euros. Now I can buy it from my friend above, André, for 250,000 euros. And it will drop when the scale goes up. So, and that's approximately it. I thank you very much.
Thank you so much, René. Yeah.